New York City crime scene. So all police officers, all FBI agents and detectives, I welcome you here in our quarterly meet of New York Police Department. To start with, I have called this meet to give a very important information to you. I have a strategy in my mind that I discussed with my blue team. Yes, that's true. After studying the past crime history of New York City, we have formed a blue team of senior police officers, top level FBI agents and detectives to find out ways of how we can make New York City crime free. And I'm here to share all those details with you. But to start with, let me deal into the history. Let me dig a little deeper into the history of New York City. So New York City, we have studied the past year and we have seen there had been a massive 500 cases of murder. There have been 700 odd cases of robbery. There have been 120 cases of domestic violence. This has shaken up the New York City and we were really worried that why the crime rate was going high. The crime rate was higher by 20% from 2012 in 2013. That's why we took a decision of forming the Blue Team. And I'm here to present to you findings of Blue Team. The first thing that we have decided to improve on in New York Police Department is that we are going to implement a four-step process. Yes, you heard it right. A four-step process with which we will strive to make New York a better city or a crime-free city. So the first step of this four-step process happens to be problem classification. So in problem classification, what we are going to do is we are going to take data of all the crimes that are happening in New York and we are going to divide those problems into simple incidents and serious incidents. When we talk about simple incidents, those are incidents that can be solved instantly with little bit of police officers. Let's say there's a robbery that happened on the road, or let's say there is a traffic disruption that happened, or let's say there is some small problem, burglary, that can be, or pickpocketing that happened. So we will classify those problems as simple incidents. And second set of problems, there are more serious problems. Those are the problems that will take a lot of time in solving, like murder. Murder case can drag on for years and years. Or another case could be bank robbery. Bank robbery case can be driven for years and years. So we will classify the problems as simple incidents that can be solved instantly in a day. And another serious cases that will take a lot of time to solve. So this is the first step, problem classification. Second step that Blue Team has decided to implement is analysis of those problems. We will analyze those problems very rigorously. Not a simple analysis, but our detectives and all investigators would go on the spot and they would rigorously check. They would ask questions to each and every witness, to each and every suspect, that how the crime happened. And according to that, we will try to find a pattern. Let's say in a particular area, let's say Manhattan City, if there are many burglaries that are happening, so we will try to uncover pattern that at what time it happens, how was the environment, who were the suspects that were present at that place. We will try to find a pattern that if one crime is happening, why it is happening in one area again and again and again. This is how we will do the problem analysis. Third thing that we will do after analysis is taking action. Now while taking action, we will assign cases according to the rank of police. So let's say if it is a simple case, it would be assigned to a very junior officer who can solve it. And if it's a serious case, then top ranking police officers and FBI agents would get that case and they would work on that case. So that's how a assignment of cases would happen based on simple incident or serious incidents. And last step, to track all the cases, we would have our monthly meetings. Like this meeting we have on a quarterly basis, but now we are going to start monthly meetings wherein all those cases would be tracked and we would see the status of each case. Like where are we standing as far as particular case is concerned? Are we moving ahead or are we not moving ahead? What is the situation like? And based on that, if the case is not moving ahead, we would change our action plan. So this is the four-step method that we are going to implement in New York Police Department. Let me reiterate that for you. First of all, we would classify the case as simple incidents that can be solved in a single day or serious incidents that require a lot of time to solve. Second thing is analysis. We would do rigorous analysis of all the incidents to find out pattern of the crime that is happening. Thirdly, we would do an action. We would assign proper cases to proper people or proper employees. And lastly, we will have our monthly meetings to track the status of all cases. Now, before moving ahead, let me tell you, this is not some random plan that we have come up with, but we have done a pilot run. We have done the pilot run for 3 months in Manhattan area, and the results were phenomenal. We have seen that murder rate has decreased by 50% in Manhattan. Domestic violence has decreased by 20%. That's not all. Normal day-to-day disruption that happens by goons, local goons, even that has come down. We have taken feedback, we have conducted survey, and results are very positive. People are living in a more positive environment out there. So I'm sure that with pilot run, if we can make Manhattan a little bit criminal-free, that after 1 year, we can surely aim to make New York a crime-free city. So are you with me on that?
Yes.
Thank you. So that's what I expect. So let's work together hand in hand and let's strive to make New York a crime-free city. Thank you. Now floor is open for question and answer for 2 to 3 minutes if you have any queries.
Can you tell us something more about the pilot program?
Pilot program, yes. So what we did, we took our top level FBI agents, we took our top level police officers. So we had a team of 50 people with us. We went there and we tried to pinpoint some certain cases, like say murder. There were 10 murders in that area in the past 3 months. There were 20 cases of robberies. So we kind of delegated the work to detectives also. And then all those detectives, they tried to find out pattern. Like whenever they had the suspect, they not only tried to ask questions that try to uncover that if this suspect did pickpocketing or murder, but they also went a step ahead and tried to ask questions like why he did that crime and what is the reason that criminals are doing that. A team of psychologists were also there, were trying to uncover psychology of those criminals, and accordingly we are trying to, you know, our aim is to make New York criminal free. So we are trying our best to get to the root of the problem and then nip it in the bud.
Your entire model of the four-step model looks very reactive to me. That means once a crime has happened, then you start working towards it. Do you have any strategy and plan to have some proactive model so that crime is prevented before it happens? So do you have something on in pipeline, any preventive strategy? It's totally a reactive model.
I totally understand your point. The thing, as I said to Ron, we are also trying to get into the root of the problem. See, this is the first time we are implementing. There would definitely be challenges that we will face. But yes, we are having a team of psychologists with us. So we will kind of do a grilling of criminals and try to find out that why do they conduct these crimes? What is their mindset? So accordingly, we are trying to uncover pattern. And once we get the pattern that, let's say, burglary happens a lot in Manhattan area, so why there? Or are there any specific people who are causing the problem or who are causing the disruption? So it is based on the pattern. So I'm sure with time the process will mature and from reactive we'll move on to the proactive part.
Thank you. Well,
we are in the first iteration of deploying this model. So obviously we have not thought about it. But yes, as in when we'll move and the process will mature, we'll definitely delegate it.
One question. See, after it will be in newspapers that, you know, children are committing a lot of crimes, killing the teachers. So, I mean, basically, you know, it's alarming to the teachers. So, how do you like it? What are the measures you're taking about such issues with children? Because they're very, very juvenile, very tender there. How do you manage those situations?
Yes, so as I said to Ron, that up till now in all the models, psychologists were never involved. So maybe we'll try to pinpoint that who are the children who are causing those problems, and then maybe we can give them counseling.
Okay.
So that's a very good point that you have brought us up. We will definitely work on that. We'll take this in the idea, in our idea list, and we will try to counsel all those juvenile cases.
Thank you.
Due to paucity of time, I'm sorry, but I have to wrap this up meeting here. Thank you.